You know, during this time, we want to hear from some of our leaders. Any information is good information. So joining us now is Jefferson County legislator and someone I have a great deal of respect for, Bobby Cantwell. Bobby, it's great to see you. How are you and your family doing?
Well, first of all, good morning, Alex. Thank you for reaching out and asking. Everybody's healthy, a little emotionally drained. Being quarantined, we know we have to do our part, and like everybody else. So, but everybody's happy and healthy at this point. We're good. Thank you.
Great. Well, you know, golf courses, marinas now officially closed. Some people were surprised by this because these were outdoor things that you could do while practicing social distancing. But obviously, there are some dangers there because they decided to close them.
Yeah. Right off the bat, it surprised me. The executive order came down yesterday. I was surprised because one would naturally think that boating on the St. Lawrence River or getting out on a golf course while practicing social distancing, being responsible, would be something that would be encouraged. But at the end of the day, this COVID-19 virus is something that we're not well-versed in, and it's not good. Once in a lifetime, once in a generational thing. So this is all, there's no rule book here, unfortunately. So it's impacting a tremendous amount of people.
You and I are both Clayton residents, and our area highly reliant on the tourism business. A lot of city folks have summer homes in our Thousand Islands region. They think, and it sounds good in theory, right? I'm going to come stay in my summer home on my island or in a secluded area and quarantine there. But while they're coming, they're using our grocery stores, using our gas stations, and spreading germs there. So the conflicting view here, though, Bobby, is we're so reliant on them for our economy. We want to be welcoming to them, but also we don't want to welcome their germs. So what's the view here?
Yeah, very, very conflicting reports here, or opinions, if you will. Cape Vincent Clayton's no different than any other region that welcomes our snowbirds. There's two different people we're talking about here, snowbirds versus the tourists. Right now, our snowbirds are coming back. It's kind of hard to tell them. They traditionally own the property that they're coming to. Could be their second house, could be their third house. I personally don't care, but the fact of the matter is they own that property. So the crux in the whole matter here is, the virus, right? They potentially could spread. So, the governor took the county's executive orders away. Everybody said, why did Jefferson County not implement, a ban? We legally cannot. But for me, I don't think that's the right thing to do, first of all. But what we can ask the snowbirds when they return is to quarantine themselves, give themselves 14 days. We as their neighbors, their family, help them out. We could be the ones going to the grocery store, bringing supplies to them.
Great. Now, to that point, a lot of our local businesses are seasonal, expected to make their profits in 3-4, at the most 5 or 6 months. How is the county, how is the government, how is we as normal everyday citizens, How are these businesses going to get helped? How are they going to stay open? And how are they going to sustain through this?
Well, again, there's no roadmap here. This is, territory we've never been in. I can tell you that from a county perspective, from a state perspective, and a federal government perspective, we're going to do everything we can to help reassure the citizens of, Northern New York, as well as New York State, and good old US of A. At the end of the day, the economy is being affected immensely right now, not only just on a local level from our wonderful Northern New York, but state, federal, globally. Just here locally in Jefferson County, sales tax, these businesses that you're talking about, they generate sales tax. Sales tax will be down immensely. That will hugely impact a lot of federal, a lot of government budgets, your local village and town budgets. Immensely, it's a large portion, if not most of their revenue for their budgets. But your initial question was in regards to local businesses, and this is impacting every business, big and small. They're the backbone. Local entrepreneurialism is what this country was built on, and I have a passion for it. I know that many businesses around here have the same passion. They're hurting. You know, we rely on the snowbirds to come back, you know, and spend some money. That's a big part of our economy here. Tourism is a huge part of our economy. I mean, globally it is, but I know you're specifically talking about here along, you know, northern New York. And we rely, the 3-4 months is huge. We work, you know, we've been working forever. Different communities have, chambers have tried to push those bookends out, right, to our seasonal bookends, making spring and fall more, finding more events. So it's tough that we're missing these spring events that we have right now, i.e. boat shows, conventions, things like that, that are inside this time of year. But Alex, you know, a small, maybe little bright light, can't even imagine if we started this sometime in June, COVID decided to rear its ugly head in June, and we missed June, July, and August. And maybe we still will. I mean, that's to be seen, yeah.
Well, Bobby, I know that you don't have a lot of answers. I don't think anybody really does. Thank you for the information that you were able to provide. And sure. I hope that you and Kelly and everybody in your family is staying healthy. And as you get more information, I know that you will share it with us, and we'd be happy to do this again.
Absolutely. Thank you, Alex. I appreciate the time, and you take